Okay, let's be honest. What guy doesn't want a perfect 10? But unless you live in Denmark, there simply aren't enough of them to go around. So they get to choose. And guess what? They want the most bang for their buck. Basic business rules. That's why they say they want someone from the 8-inch club. And if you're a member with that kind of member, congratulations! In theory. Because in practice, it might not be what you think. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health, and in this video, I'll reveal what's really behind the cult of the 8-inch club. I'm proud to be one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. Not because I follow trends, but because I am the trend. So don't subscribe to AI copycats, subscribe to the original. Besides, you can't become a patient with a content farm, but you can with me. So, why is it so hard to impress a perfect 10? Because she plays in a league of her own. If you play mini league, that won't impress her. We'll get to that in a moment. But the burning question why you clicked on this video is this: are perfect 10s into large penises? Honestly, between us, probably they are. I know what many of you are saying right now. I knew it. And yes, if we wanted to keep it on the surface, the video could come to an end here. But hey, this is UroChannel, and you didn't come here for shallow talk. Of course, there's a hidden structure, a game she has to play, a game the so-called 8-inchers get trapped in. Because like a perfect 10, 8-inch penises are extraordinarily rare. Similarly to being a perfect 10, being in the 8-inch club is a ticket to a parallel universe. Likewise, it has become an online myth. Average penis size is roughly 5.5 inches. 6 inches is the perceived average, and the world fantasizes about the 8-inch penis. See, a perfect 10 learns about her extraordinary status from early on in life. Long before she knows what it means, she knows what she does to a room, to a crowd, to the boys in her class. That silence when she enters, that electricity, it's not earned, it just is. That they stand out, that men react to them, that they have power over others. These are the corners of their universe. Standing out, being noticed, having power. The perfect 10 and the 8-inch guy play by the same rules. Principally, it's the same game. Now it's up to them to decide, do they want to play that game and be someone, or stay true to themselves and become invisible? If they want to stay on top, they'll have to fulfill everyone's expectations. Let me give you a few examples. And maybe, just maybe, you'll start to hear echoes from a long-forgotten place. That moment when you were 21, on your own, in the city for the first time, everything smelled like freedom and fear. If I just touched that nerve, give this video a like. And if you want more of that rare feeling, boost it. Let the algorithm know it's not alone. Now, here are some examples. A Hollywood movie star who shows up at the red carpet with his partner from high school? It's a visual mismatch. Everybody would go, couldn't he possibly have a more suitable partner? The perfect 10 going to prom night with a school nerd, a common theme in movies. It shows to the world that she is more than just looks, that she has the guts to do that. Works in the movies, but in real life, let's face it, she would go from being a 10 to being a 7 just because of that. And this is the very reason she has no choice but demand the 8-inch penis, because she is entitled to. So the young 10s say things like, size matters, he better be packing. Most of them have no physical understanding of what that really means. It's like talking shop about sports cars and never been in one. Most of them would be frightened if they saw an 8-inch penis in real life. Realizing what it actually means, 8 inches, could come like a shock. Science knows about this gap. This is why one of the few studies that assessed size used 3D models. Women were not just to name their preferences, but they were given real models. The intention was to filter out unrealistic preferences made by the subjective assumption how a large penis actually would look like. So the perfect 10 with the 8-inch guy? If looks are the foundation of their relationship, maybe not the perfect match. But picture this, being a 10 is not a choice. It's a rubber stamp they get from others. Men would say, you're a 10. Friends would say, you're pretty, you've got it easy. Instagram says, 10K likes, must be a 10. And somewhere along the line, they start to believe it. This is why the call for an 8-inch penis is only logical, because it's a myth, it's status. Not officially wanting one would be to reject Harvard and attend community college. What she doesn't realize is that she is falling for a myth that destroys men and isolates her. If you're still with me, subscribe. Now's a good time. But now let's look at the other side of this fantasy. The guy who actually has what she thinks she wants. It's the same, but more brutal. He chases the perfect 10, but not for desire, sex, love, body. He wants something different, something he may not be consciously aware of. She's his trophy. She's the symbol of his potency, his success, his freedom to choose whoever he likes. It increases his rank within the male social hierarchy. She gives him status. In summary, being together with a perfect 10 satisfies his longing for being admired by other men. But that comes at a price. She's a person, not a trophy one exhibits in the cupboard. She might change her mind and leave him. A 10-incher could come around and just grab her. So he can't be too sure whether he will be able to keep her. She's expensive. Literally, she drains him. Not because she wants to, but because the myth demands it. There are high maintenance costs linked to such a woman, so he better have a big purse. And here's where some comments of my viewers find some resonance. She's costly in energy. It's strange, isn't it? We think we're chasing women, or size, or success, but maybe, just maybe, we're chasing the moment we first felt like a man. Every man has this moment, or this period. Many men forget about it. Some never do. One of my moments? Camping on Long Beach, Vancouver Island. Summer of 88. Salt in the air. Something in me changed. So what just happened? Did you see a video about large penises and stunning women? Or did you witness something else? Something deeper. A transformation. Subscribe, share, and like if you want to see more of this. And ask yourself, does size matter to you? Maybe you're proud. Maybe you're ashamed. Either way, size still owns you. But what if it didn't? What if the real shift, the real freedom, is not in gaining inches, but in losing the need? That's the invitation to meet the women who see through the myth. Because what happens to homecoming queen and king when the curtain falls? Do they live happily ever after when beauty fades away and 8 inches just hurt? Some want it big, others don't. But who are they? And how do you know which is which? You choose. Two videos, two mindsets, two futures. Choose who you want to be. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.